Hi, I'm Terry Bozzio, and I'm here to talk about the DW Black Page Icon Snare. It's a tribute to Frank Zappa. It has his iconic mustache. It's a beautiful birdseye maple snare, and it's laser etched with the music of the Black Page, the notation. And then here where it says the Black Page, that's inlaid with black pear, which is really beautiful. So this snare drum is a great instrument, but it's really more about the tribute to the man and to his music, and I just happen to be the lucky guy who he handed the page of music to first. You know, for me, we were at rehearsal. Frank was always late. We were, you know, there for a couple hours playing and jamming and working on things, and Frank walked into the room with his, you know, monster gallon-sized coffee pot, you know, thing that he always carried around, and his briefcase. And he came into the stage and set down his stuff and popped open the briefcase and pulled out this sheet of music and handed it to me. And he said, "What do you think about this, Bozzio?" And I looked at it, and it was the Black Page. My words were, "Gee, Frank, I'm impressed." You know, it was a really complex piece of music. There were parts I could sight read, so that was no problem, but there was some, you know, as he called it, statistical density to the piece. So there was a lot of notes, and you know, I had to work on it. So I just chipped away at it for 20 minutes a day. It wasn't a pressure thing like an audition. I understand Vinny had to actually audition with the Black Page, and so I think he sight read that to get the gig with Zappa. So I can tell you that it wasn't the case with me. It wasn't a pressure thing at all. So I just chipped away at it for 20 minutes a day, and in a week or two I had it under my fingers and could play it for Frank. And at that point he took the music back and said, "Great, and I'm gonna write the melody to it." And he wrote the melody and brought that back in, and we started to play it as a band. And the rest is kind of history. I think the lore of the Black Page came from, he noticed that during the breaks, a lot of the musicians would be, you know, hanging around the coffee machine, and they seemed to be living in mortal terror that they would get called for some innocent commercial jingle on a Monday morning and be faced with a piece of music that was so filled with notes and so difficult that the page appeared black. So that was sort of the impetus and the inspiration for Frank writing his own Black Page. I just feel very lucky and grateful because it turned into something bigger than me. And that's because of the greatness of the man who composed the music. I just happened to be there at the time. He wrote it for me. He wrote it for my drum kit and the instruments that I had. And it was a through-composed classical piece. So it seemed to have, you know, taken on a life of its own. And I just happened to be the lucky guy who got all the credit for being the first one there. So that's the story of the Black Page. Now, about this snare, it's a beautiful thing. It's birdseye maple. Black pear inlay, laser engraved notation. It's got the three position snare strainer and the mag throw off, which is really great. The tuning is exceptionally fine. You know, all the bells and whistles. It comes with a beautiful black head, and the package is gonna come with a beautiful bag which has a 7-inch vinyl of me playing the Black Page, and also the sleeve of the vinyl will have the original melody that Frank wrote for the rest of the instrumentalists to play. There's only going to be 250 of them made, and I'm going to sign every head. So I should do that now, and then I'll leave it to you collectors to snatch up the 250 before they're all gone. And there it is. Thank you, Frank.